Hello, language learners. In this video, let's learn some English from Russell Crowe. In this interview, he is speaking about his time working on one of his most iconic films, Gladiator. As always, we will focus on understanding spoken English. Let's listen.
When I went to meet Ridley, I looked like absolute shit.
Ridley is a reference to Ridley Scott, the director of Gladiator.
I don't see how he could possibly have seen me as a Roman general, but we really got on.
To get on with someone is a phrasal verb that means you have a good, friendly relationship with someone.
But we really got on. He had gigantic ideas and like kind of thought most of them were impossible, really.
Kinda was a reduction of kind of.
Kinda thought.
Kinda.
Kinda thought.
Kinda thought.
Kinda thought most of them were impossible, really. And it certainly wasn't on the page. There was no script that we could be enthused about.
To be enthused is to be excited.
Be enthused about.
To be enthused about.
Be enthused about. Be enthused about.
He uses this word again in a second.
But what I was enthused about was the simple idea. It's 184 AD or 180 AD. You're a Roman general and you're being directed by Ridley Scott.
180 AD.
180 AD. 180 AD.
AD means in the year of the Lord in Latin and refers to the birth of Jesus Christ. Before this year, zero, let's say, we use BC for before Christ. You may also see publications using CE, which means common era, and BCE for before common era. Which one do you prefer? I grew up with BC and AD, but I'm seeing CE and BCE used more and more. Honestly, I prefer BC and AD, but maybe that just means I'm getting old.
It's 184 AD or 180 AD. You're a Roman general and you're being directed by Ridley Scott. You know, so that drove my motivation a lot.
Let's note that he uses the typical filler, you know, quite often in this interview. As always, just ignore this.
You know, it was very difficult putting on those clothes and going, oh yeah, okay, off we go. I'm a Roman general. And I know that Joaquin Phoenix had the same problem because we talked about it, you know?
Because is reduced to cuz.
Because we talked about it, you know?
Cuz.
Because we talked about it, you know? The heights that those characters had to go to, you know?
He means the emotional heights, the high level of emotion the characters in the film had to show.
It was, and it's very different because at that stage,
a little fragmenting and filler here as he thinks. At that stage means at that time, at that point in time.
At that stage, you know, if you're wearing clothes like that, you're probably doing a comedy or a piss take.
A piss take is informal language. In many English countries, to take the piss out of means to make fun of someone or something. Don't translate this word for word, okay? It doesn't make sense. Just translate the big idea. This expression is used widely in the UK, Ireland, South Africa, New Zealand, and Australia. It's not used in the US. So a piss take is a noun derived from this verb.
Piss take, piss take, piss take. You know, sword and sandal things had been out of vogue for, you know, a long time.
Sword and sandal movies is a genre of films, specifically films set in ancient Rome or ancient Greece.
You know, sword and sandal things had been out of vogue for, you know, a long time.
To be out of vogue means to be out of fashion, to be untrendy. So before Gladiator, there had been a long period where filmmakers didn't make movies set in ancient Rome.
That whole idea was constructed around the sincerity of the core journey of a man's vengeance for the death of his wife and child.
Note Russell Crowe's accent on core journey, main journey.
Of the core journey.
Core journey.
Of the core journey.
Core journey.
Of the core journey of a man's vengeance for the death of his wife and child.
I'll have my vengeance. This life or the next.
It's funny though, you see the backstage or behind the scenes footage and everybody's just goofing around and being silly. And
to goof around means to make jokes. Think of the Disney character Goofy. Goofy. So to act stupid and silly.
And everybody's just goofing around and being silly and
goofing around.
Goofing around.
Goofing around.
Goofing around. Goofing around. You know, the reason you do that is you're saving all your serious shit for after the guy says action, you know?
The word shit is often used informally in English to mean things. So here, he means save your serious things, meaning your serious acting and serious behavior.
You know, the reason you do that is you're saving all your serious shit for after the guy says action, you know?
Here is a quick list of some of the vocabulary from today's lesson. And if you want more English listening from actors, check out one of these videos.